Today I'm gonna show you guys how I'm gonna build a Rocky diorama. Welcome back, collectors. So in the last video, I showed you guys how I did a draft using Photoshop. And after that draft, what is gonna happen next? We're gonna create the diorama. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to use power tools, pine bark, and some epoxy to create a very, very realistic rock diorama, which is very eye-catching. And after all, this was supposed to be one of my Golden Demon entries. So if you're ready, let us begin. So now we're gonna start building our diorama. The first step is I have to start removing all this excess base material from this. And I'm gonna use my trusty power tool. So I'm gonna start by drilling in some checkpoints. So as mentioned before, our first step will be drilling checkpoints. Checkpoints are very easy to drill. Just need to drill holes which are relatively near to each other, because this will help guide the drill in the desired form and shape that you want to do. So after the checkpoints are done, as you can see, the drill just goes through the holes like butter, and very soon you can remove the entire excess base area so that you can work. And here you see the excess base has been removed. Very, very simple. Okay, so once the excess base is removed, I'm gonna use a grinding pad to sort of like grind away the areas that are sticking out. I want the base to be as flat as possible so that it's gonna be easy to work with. So just using this grinding pad, I'm removing as much material as I can and making sure the surface is flat before I move on to the next step. So the next step will involve a bit of AB epoxy. What I use Magic Sculpt AB epoxy. So I just need to make sure that it mixes really well, one to one. And I'm going to use the epoxy to fill up the empty gap in the base so that the tree bark can be stuck. So a good tip working with pine bark is you want to use your hands to start breaking apart the bark so that you achieve the shape that you want to do. This also allows it to look a little bit more like slate. Okay, so using a bit more epoxy, I'm going to just attach very roughly some of the pine bark onto the base so that I can move on to the next stage. So use a bit of super glue also. The super glue helps the pine bark stick to the epoxy. Super glue only works when there's surface area for the pine bark to adhere to. So yeah, that's why we use the epoxy to sort of create some surface area. And for the last part, you know, just use a bit of epoxy to cover up the entire base so that the entire rock formation looks as seamless and as natural as possible. Okay, just touch a bit of super glue here and you're done for this stage. So the next stage we're going to start grinding down the bark. So using the drill tool, what we're doing, we're smoothening out the bark so that while there are some layers, we don't need to have too many layers. So we are trying to like merge some very, very thin layers together to simulate the impression of slate rock. Bark breaks the same way as slate rock does, because slate rock exists in very thin sheets. Therefore, bark is a very good replacement, and the benefit of using bark is that you can carve it rather than chip it off with slate rock. So continue using the drill and just clearing up the diorama. Okay, as you can see right here. Next, I'm gonna use the carbide disc. So with the carbide disc, I'm gonna cut flat planes onto the sculpted rocks. So these sculpted rocks are very easy to sculpt. You just need to mold a little ball and just stick it on with a little bit of super glue. It helps to use super glue rather than just pressing it on, because super glue allows it to stick to the model rather than just sort of like just adhering to it. So with this smaller grinding disc, I'm creating some motting effects onto the model so that when you spray prime it, it has a bit of texture rather than it being perfectly smooth. So right now what we're doing, we're gonna use a bit of little rocks So we don't need to carve all the other rocks. These rocks are more generic, so I want to have a mix of material so that it gives a bit of visual interest to the entire diorama. Okay, so now done, we're going to add on some skulls to finish off the diorama. So these skulls are from Games Workshop. They are really versatile. Bunch of skulls and different sculpts, so you just want to put it over the diorama. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus on the main angle where the Lord Arcanum is exploring, and I'm going to have a pile of skulls to sort of like signify why this Lord Arcanum is using this area and is interested in this area.
So that's how I build my competition pieces and how I continue to build them and develop this technique. This technique is slowly developed over the years, and yeah, this is where it is right now, and I hope you like it. So let me know in the comments below. So as you guys have followed, we have gone from Photoshop draft to building the diorama, and up next, what we're gonna do, we're gonna use some lights and understand the lights and shadows before we start painting anything. So from this video, we split up to non-metallic metal, how to paint OSL, and so on and so forth. So if you found this video useful, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell notification icon so that you know when we post the next videos. So we post every Tuesday, Thursdays, and Saturdays, and sometimes in between if you are lucky. So if you really want to support the channel, please head on to our Patreon. Patreons get early access to many of my tutorials and some exclusive content also. So I hope to see you in the next video where we'll be playing with lights and hopefully understanding more about the diorama. Alright, see you.